Good morning, everyone. Let's get started on time. So the first speaker should be Victor Shenavrin, but I heard from Vladimir that he's going to make the presentation instead of Victor, who's unable to attend. Please, Vladimir.
Victor Shenavrin is my Victor Shenavrin is my co-author, and he could not unfortunately visit Petersburg and asked me to give his talk. This is all our team from different institutes, and the goal of this investigation is to study the infrared activity of UXOrs stars and to compare this activity with optical, with photometric activity in optical region. All infrared observations were made in the same telescope with the same equipment, and this, you see the list of our target. This is the most active UXOrs stars. Optical photometry, which we used, was obtained in Grinin Observatory by our group, and also with ASAS and American Amateur Astronomers. This is our publications. We added the last observations, including the last observational seasons, in all figures which you will see. This you see our very briefly some our results. We observed in the infrared bands the variability which correlate in these optical changes, but this correlation is not this correlation observed not in all bands and not in all stars. This is RR tau. You see the light curves from L to G, and this is optical variability. Optical variability, the amplitude reach about 3 stellar magnitude, and you see that there are the very good correlation with some optical events, for example here, but in some cases we see the opposite changes here and here. The other object, UXOrs itself, you see the same picture. Large-scale variability in optical region and the activity in the infrared bands with a different amplitude. The amplitude of activity decrease from G to L bands. And again, we see some common events in visual and infrared regions, but we see also the opposite changes here and here. WW Vulpecula, very good studied in the visual regions. You see here the light curve from 3 sources. And this is infrared light curves. And again, the same situation. There are some events which have continuation in the infrared region, and there are events which has not such continuation. For example, this. We don't see anything here. Sikutau. This is most active in visual regions. UXOR. And the same is true for G band. In all other bands, correlation also exists, and you see the coefficient of correlation here in this part. And correlation is quite good in three bands and more or less good in L band with optical. SVCFA. This is most interesting result of our group. This star demonstrates the stochastic variability in visual region in optical wavelengths. And you see the wave-like changes in the infrared region, which has not common with visual variations. And here we see also the coefficient of correlations, optical region, G, H, K, and L band. And you see the correlation is small, even not very large, even between V and G. And here we see the anti-correlation even. This is a very strange and not very clear results from physical properties of this object. This is all coefficient of correlation for all objects, our program. And I can repeat only that we have the bad correlation between optical and infrared region for SVCFA, good correlation between infrared bands, of course. And you see some interesting properties for CO ORI, good correlation between V, G, H, K, and bad correlation between G and L. We used a very simple model for wave-like explanation of the wave-like variability of SVCFA, and we have found that this variability is a result of variations of the nearest to the star region of circumstellar disk. In this region, the dust is evaporated already, and this is approximate temperature of the gas which responsible for wave-like variability of SVCFA. And this means that in this UXOR, the main source of infrared variations in G, H, K, and L band give the nearest to the star region, but not this, but as in other objects. And this is this result is not very clear. The reason of this property is not very clear, but we assume that it is caused by almost edge on orientation of this protoplanetary disk. Probably this is all. Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Questions, please. I take first.
Okay, SV Cepheus is a Hebig, a spectral type, simply saying. What is spectral type? Hebig star or Chitauri?
The time of observations? Not in this list of target, only CO Ori may be considered as object intermediate between Herbig and Tetauri stars, but we have not any Tetauri stars in our list.
Yeah, can you explain how you constrain the variability of SV Ceph B inside the dust sublimation radius?
Thank you for very good questions. We use very simple model. In infrared region, we can approximate the radiation of the star by Planck. Yes. We use the Planck for infrared observations, and we try to find the temperature of this additional radiation, which can explain the amplitude of the wave-like variability. This is our way.
I have a question. Have you tried if there is any phase shift, or the, for example, the L band and the optical band, that if you phase shift the observations, that then you have increased the correlation?
But in case of SVCF,
for example,
But the absence of a correlation between visual region and infrared region in this object may be a result of orientation of the disk, not under small inclination angle as in other UXOR, but almost edge on. Because we have, in this case, also the large extinction in the bright state of the star. This is an additional argument for such orientation. Maybe this object, similar to HH30. In HH30, I remember that we have also the optical variability, and we have periodical, maybe, or quasi-periodical changes of the shape of this object, shape of the disk around it. Maybe this Cepheus is similar case. It, unfortunately, this object cannot be observed with ALMA.
Any further questions? If not, let's thank Vladimir again.